Okay, this lesson comes from the notes page for limiting values and behavior and asymptotes. So let's pick up on page 2 where we have kind of mentioned asymptotes with exponential functions. Exponential functions, they all have some sort of horizontal asymptote, because all exponential functions are going to level off at some value, either in the positive infinity direction or the negative infinity direction. Alright, so here's the formal definition of horizontal and vertical asymptotes. A horizontal asymptote, it's a straight horizontal line, always in the form of y equals the number. Alright, and so sometimes people just put the number. Well, you have to give me the equation of a line. So this y equals is important. And it's associated with a curve that indicates that a curve is heading towards the y value represented by the horizontal asymptote as x gets very large in the positive or negative direction. So we saw that. As x gets really large in this positive direction, as x approaches infinity, y approaches zero. So that's how the language for horizontal asymptotes work. Here, as x approaches negative infinity, y approaches zero. All right. So the horizontal asymptote idea has to do with what happens when x gets very large. So the horizontal asymptote idea is about what happens when x gets very large, positive or negative. Right. And the graph is going to show up like a horizontal line. Both functions above have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. Alright, because in graph 1, as x approaches large numbers, the function's value approaches 0. And in graph 2, as x approaches very small numbers, the function value approaches 0. Okay, so that's vertical asymptotes. Alright. That's horizontal asymptotes. Alright, let's look at vertical asymptotes. So, the vertical asymptote is a straight vertical line, always in the form of x equals a number. I can't tell you how many times I have to, if I'm in a CD class, many times I have to say it. I'll say, what's the vertical asymptote? And someone will say, 2. And I'll say, that's a number. What's the vertical asymptote? X equals 2. Because you have to represent, you have to use the language of math, it's a line. And the equation of a line that's a vertical line always has an x in front of it. Okay, so the vertical asymptote is associated with a curve that indicates x values that are not included in the domain of the function. So that's when the idea becomes different. X values that are not included in the domain of the function. So we've kind of touched on it. For example, let's say I have f of x equals 1 over x plus 2. All right, we should know, every math student should know that you're not allowed to have 0 in the bottom of the function. Well, if x were to equal negative 2, we would get 1 over 0, which is bad. That's not a number. So that means that x is not allowed to be negative 2. So negative 2 is not in the domain. It's a restriction. It's not in the domain. And the way it will show up is it'll show up as a vertical asymptote. X equals negative 2. So, first thing I want to say is that horizontal asymptotes and vertical asymptotes are similar in that they are dashed lines that appear in a function, but the ideas are different. The horizontal asymptote has to do with end behavior. But the vertical asymptote has to do with restrictions on the domain, which is math talk for x can't be certain things. Domain means set of x coordinates. Okay, so we're going to use this time, since we're just looking at the graphs, we're going to throw in some logarithmic functions, which might be uncomfortable because you may not have used logarithmic functions before, but it's okay because all we're going to look at in this unit is just the graph. So if you take a look at this graph, something weird seems to be happening. This is a picture of a log function, and it's slight, but it seems to be increasing. It doesn't seem to be leveling off. So there's not a horizontal asymptote, but it does seem to be trying to hug this vertical x-axis here. So turns out that there is a vertical asymptote at x equals 0. Same thing here for this log function. It's kind of getting level off, but no, it's got to be pretty obvious. This is continuing to get, the y values are getting smaller and smaller and smaller, but it seems to be not wanting to pass this vertical line right here at x equals 0. Alright, and so this log function, which is f of x equals log base a of x, and you may not know anything about that, but that's a log function. It has a vertical asymptote just by looking at the graph of x equals 0. I can't resist it. I have to tell you why that is, because I want to illustrate that the definitions of these two, the ideas, are different. So remember, vertical asymptote deals with restrictions on the domain. It turns out that a log function, see this spot right here? You're not allowed to have any negative numbers in there. That spot right there, and you can't have 0 either. This has a domain restriction, and you'll have to memorize it. We're a little ahead of the game, but the reason that you've got a vertical asymptote there is that because that spot right there must be greater than 0. And so you can see that not only is it not touching it, this vertical asymptote, it can't go past it because x cannot be negative, so none of these negative x values are allowed to be put in there, and that's why the functions look the way they look. Alright, let's look at page 2 and look at rational functions. Now, rational functions are interesting because they have both vertical and horizontal asymptotes, so the asymptotes mean the different things, but good news is they're going to show up in the graph, and hopefully you'll be able to locate those. So if you look at this one, there's two branches. That's a rational function, so we know we have to memorize what things are. And it seems like these two branches don't want to touch the line, this vertical line right here. And it also seems like these two branches don't want to touch this horizontal line right there. So rational functions can have both horizontal and vertical asymptotes. So if I ask you to name the vertical asymptote, you can't get it switched. You have to make sure you remember the vertical asymptote is the vertical line and it's crossing through the x-axis, so it's x equals 0. And what is the horizontal asymptote? That's the horizontal line and it's crossing through the y-axis, so that's y equals 0. And these two things, getting a little ahead, mean different things. This vertical asymptote x equals 0 means that x cannot be 0. There's 0 is not allowed in the domain. But this y equals 0 means a different thing. It means end behavior. So if we can practice that, how would you fill this in? Look at the graph. As x gets really, really, really big and heads towards infinity, look at how it's leveling off. Y is just leveling off at 0. And as x gets really, really, really small, or x goes to negative infinity, y is leveling off at 0. So remember, the horizontal asymptote, when you have that right end behavior, is going to be the length of what y is approaching. There. So two different ideas. This is saying that x, that 0 is not in the domain. This horizontal asymptote talks about end behavior. Alright, so you may want to practice. You can turn off the video, pause the video, and see if you can determine all the asymptotes for the following graphs. Alright, so this first one, you might want to name the graphs too. This first one seems to be leveling off right here. Excuse my shaky hand there. That's a horizontal line of y equals 5. So it has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 5, but it does not have a vertical asymptote. And what kind of function is this? This is an exponential function. And is it growth or decay? Exponential. And it's increasing as we go to the right. So this is growth. Just extra review questions. It does not have a vertical asymptote. This has to do with end behavior. Can you fill in this blank? Said this is the thing people are missing, so kind of a little bit more emphasis on it this time. Can you fill in the blank? As x goes to the right, positive infinity, look at y is going up. And as x goes to the left of negative infinity, y is leveling off at the number 5. Alright, the second one, do you know what type of function that is? That's a log arithmetic function. We call it log functions. Alright, does it have an asymptote? Don't be fooled here. I'm glad this one's on here. People are fooled into thinking that that's a horizontal asymptote there, but a logarithmic function does not have a horizontal asymptote. It's increasing very, very slowly, but it is increasing. So this one does not have a horizontal asymptote, but it does have a vertical asymptote. And there are limitations on the graph, so it looks like it's touching negative 5, but you need to know log functions have vertical asymptotes. This particular vertical asymptote is x equals negative 5. And what that means is that x cannot be negative 5. And in fact, for logs, you don't need to know this yet, x can't be less than negative 5. None of that matters. All you need to know is that there is no horizontal asymptote. No, it looks like it's leveling off. It's not. It's slightly increasing. And there's a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 5. Alright. What are the asymptotes for this one? This is a rational function. Because it has two branches. And this one actually has both a vertical asymptote and a horizontal asymptote. So the vertical asymptote, now look at this example. You have to pay attention to what we're counting by. There's a 20 over here, which means that each of these is counting, we're counting by 5s. So I've had people miss problems because of that. Be careful. I've actually missed it rushing, so. All right. So this is a vertical asymptote, x equals 5. And this is a horizontal asymptote, y equals 10. And I'm just getting you prepared for future lessons, so we can say these mean different things. This vertical asymptote is telling me that x cannot be 5. 5 can't be in the domain. Okay, you are not going to need to talk about that. This is all you're going to have to do. This y equals 10 is telling me something different. Now this you may need to do. This is end behavior. As x approaches positive infinity, means you look at this function as x goes to the right. What does this y value seem to be approaching? Here's your y axis. And remember I said, whatever this is, excuse me, make sure. Okay. Whatever this is, the horizontal asymptote right here, that's what's going to go in this spot right here. As x goes to the right, y is approaching the number 10. And as x goes to the left, or negative infinity, same thing. Y is approaching the number 10. All right, what are the vertical and horizontal asymptotes of this rational function? This is also a rational function. Sometimes you can have more than one vertical asymptote. That can happen. So basically, when you have a bunch of branches split up by vertical asymptotes, that's a rational function. So we have two vertical asymptotes. We have, let's see what we're counting by. Counting by 5s again. Okay. So we have a vertical asymptote at x equals 10 and another vertical asymptote at x equals negative 10. there's a horizontal asymptote at y equals 5. And again, they mean different things. This is saying that x can't be 10 or negative 10. This is saying that as x approaches infinity, y approaches 5, and as x approaches negative infinity, y approaches 5. And this is interesting. This is talking about end behavior. So as x approaches infinity, y approaches 5, but for small values of x, y has some values. It's only for large values of x that y approaches 5.